In this video, we're going to be adding bookmarks and chapters to our custom audio player that we've built in React. Let's go. If you're new to the Self-Teach Me channel, my name is Amy Dutton. I'm a web designer and developer. If you're looking to get into this space, sometimes it's hard to know where to start and what resources to trust. I want to help you level up and get to where you want to be. If this sounds interesting to you, hit the subscribe button below. Real quick, before we get going, I want to point out that this video is part 3 of a multi-part series on building a custom audio player in React. In the first video, we built the whole thing from scratch. And as I mentioned earlier, in this video, we'll take a step further and add a bookmark or chapter. Right now, we're using this feature within the sponsor dashboard. Each of the sponsors gets access to their own dashboard where they can log in and see a history of their contracts and invoices, as well as the stats for all the episodes they've sponsored. There we highlight their sponsor placement. That way they can listen to their ad read without having to listen to the entire episode. Unless, of course, they just really want to listen to the entire episode. Last piece of housekeeping. I've listed timestamps in the description below in case you want to jump around. And with that, let's jump into the code. If you want to follow along, I'll include a link in the description below to the code that I'm starting out with. But basically, we're starting exactly where we left off in the last video. So you'll want to jump over to GitHub, download or clone the repository. So we can copy that link, open our terminal, and we'll run git clone. We'll paste in that URL. Then let's go inside that folder. And we'll want to run npm install, and this will grab all the dependencies our project needs. And then we can run npm run dev. And here's the URL. And we are off to the races. Once it's up and running, you should see our lovely audio player. The first thing that we're going to do is set up a static or a hard-coded in bookmark. These will eventually be dynamic, but this will allow us to set up our styles and then we can make it dynamic later. So let's just take the less complicated approach. Let's open our code within VS Code and make this a little bit bigger. Ooh, too big. I'll close out all of this. Awesome. So the first thing I'm going to do is open our audioplayer.js, and that lives inside our components directory. And this is where all the code for our audio player lives. And ultimately, these chapters need to appear on top of our range slider. So I'm going to jump down to our slider in our HTML right there. Right next to our slider, I'm going to add a div for our chapter. If you'll remember from the first video where we did most of the styling, we're using CSS modules. And when we define our class name, we need to use curly brackets and inside say styles dot the name of our CSS class. So let's call this chapter. And I'm gonna open up our CSS file, which is in the styles folder, and it's called audioplayer.module.css. At the very bottom of our file, I'm gonna create a class called chapter. Let's move this up. And I want the display to be black. I'm going to give it a height of 11 pixels, which is the same height as our progress bar, so we can be consistent there. I want the background color to be a hot pink. And we've already defined this within a CSS variable at the top of our file. So if we take a look, here are our variables, and our hot pink is called primary. So let's go back down to the bottom. Scroll up a bit and let's say primary. Then we want to position this absolutely. So I'm going to say position absolute. And for now, I'm just going to say 4 pixels from the top. But of course, we can tweak this and dial it in later. And I'm going to make up the left and width for right now. But the easiest way to calculate these are going to be based on percentages. So for right now, we'll just say left is 45% and the width is 5%. So I'm going to give that a save, and let's jump over to the browser and see what it looks like. Okay, and it looks strange because our chapter bar is appearing at the very top of the page. And you have to remember that position is always relative. You have to look at the parent element. So if we go back to our JSX and look at our audioplayer.js file, the parent element of our chapter is this empty div without any class name. So it's positioning our chapter bar absolutely on the entire page. So we need to contain it. So I'm going to add a class to our div called styles.progressbar wrapper and give that a save. Now within our CSS, and actually let's hide the sidebar and move this over so we can see both at the same time. Now within our CSS, let's add another class called progressbar wrapper. And we'll give this a position of relative. So if I give this a save and we refresh our browser, ta-da, our chapter is appearing exactly where it's supposed to be. Now, one thing I noticed is that when we hover over our progress bar, our cursor doesn't change to a finger. So let's go back to VS Code and find our progress bar class here, and let's add a property called cursor pointer. Okay, so if we give that a save and go back to our browser, our cursor changes. But it goes back to an arrow when we hover over our chapter. And in fact, you can click on the progress bar to move the playhead around. But if you click on the chapter, nothing happens. And that's because it's sitting on top of the range slider. Basically, we want to be able to click through the chapter almost as if it's not even there. So let's jump back to VS Code and go back to our chapter style. We want to add a property called pointer events and set that to none. So if we give that a save, let's go back, and now we can, perfect. Oh, but look, if we click past our chapter, our played style covers the chapter. So this is a pretty easy fix. Our chapter style just needs to have a Z index, and our playhead or a knobby already has a Z index of 3, and we don't want it to appear on top of that. So let's give this a value of 2. Hit save. And perfect. So the layering on that is correct. Now we just need to make this dynamic. At the top of our audio player component, I'm going to create a variable to hold all of our chapter values. Eventually, we'll want to pass this in as a prop, but for now, I'm just going to hard code this in. So I'm going to say const chapters, and I want the option to be able to pass in multiple chapters to the player. So let's make this an array that we can map over. So we're going to use square brackets, and we want this to be an array of objects. So I'm going to use curly brackets to say an object. And I'll label the first property start, and we can use this to calculate our left style. So I'm just going to say 10 for right now, I'm just making this up, comma, and then we need to set an end in seconds, and we can use this to determine the width of the property. So I'm just going to say 25 for right now. Okay, I'm going to duplicate this object. So I'm going to add a comma to the end, and I'm going to change out these values. So we'll say 50 and 70. Okay, let's jump back down to our chapters div in our JSX. And let's take it one step at a time. So first I want to map over it so I can tell that it's adding two divs for two chapters. So I'm going to grab our chapters array and I'm going to map over it. And map is a built-in JavaScript method that allows us to loop over each item in our array and do something or display something. And so this takes a function, and inside, we're going to pass it two parameters. The first parameter is how we want to refer to each item in our array. So I'm going to call this chapter, but you could call it anything. A lot of times I'll name it item or one to remind me that it's one item in the array. The second parameter is the iteration. And the first time it runs, this will be 0. The second time it runs, it will be 1. The third time, 2, and so on. So it's based on a 0 scale. These parameters are just built into how map operates. So within our functions code, first let's use console.log to display our iteration. This would be a quick way to let us know how many times it's run through our map loop, once or twice. And then let's return our chapter div. So I'm gonna cut this and paste it inside our return statement. Okay, let's give this a save and run it in the browser and open up our Chrome Developer Tools. You should see something like this. It's running twice. We have our 0, 1. That's good. That's exactly what we're looking for, but we're getting this error that says each child in a list should have a unique key prop. So when you loop over code like what we're doing, React needs you to assign a key prop to each iteration to help it track all of the items. This is really easy to fix. Within VS Code, we can add a key attribute to our div, and we just need a way to uniquely identify it. Heyo, we have our I, or our iteration, so this number will be different each time we process each item on the array. Okay, so let's give that a save and refresh it within our browser, and you should see that error message go away. Cool. Okay, the last piece, we need each chapter to be displayed in the right place. So we have the start value and the end value for each chapter. that we listed up here in our chapters variable. Within our CSS, we need a way for our left and width property to be dynamic. And right now these are in seconds, but we need to convert them to a percentage of the song in order to work within our CSS. So let's just take this again, one step at a time. First, we need to calculate these. So I'm gonna jump back down to the chapters here, and I'm gonna get rid of our console.log. First, let's determine the left value, and this will be based on the start value, and we also have duration of the entire song within the state that we set up in the first video. Okay, let's create a variable called left style to hold our value. Then remember, as we're mapping over each individual item, we can reference it by saying chapter, and we want to grab the start value. Let's divide this by the duration. And since we're working in percentages, we need to multiply it times 100. Okay, now let's handle the width of our chapter. So I'm gonna call this width style, and we can say chapter.end minus chapter.start. And this will get us the length of our clip. Then, similar as before, we need to divide this by duration. So I'm gonna wrap this in parentheses, then multiply it by 100 to get the percentage. Okay, let's stick this into the console to make sure that we're getting the right values. And instead of saying console.log, let's do something a little different and say console.table. And I'm gonna pass this an object, and it will format all of our values into a nice little table within our developer tools. So I'm gonna say I, so we can check the iteration, left style, and width style. And part of the reason that this works is because it's a shorthand. In JavaScript, you can do something like this. And if the property and the value are the same, if it equals itself, you can just do this for short. Okay, so let's give this a save and check this out within the browser. Perfect. We can see that it's running twice. In the first chapter, we're at 13% with a width of 20%. The second chapter, it starts at 66% and is 26% long. Okay, now let's apply these values to our CSS. And the easiest way to do this is through CSS variables. CSS variables are scopes, so this makes this pretty easy, actually. So let's set up our CSS first. Where we define our chapter styles, let's swap out the value left for a variable. And let's just call this left. And let's do the same thing for our width. So I'm gonna say var width. Now within our component, we can set an inline style that will essentially pass these variables over to our CSS. Let's reformat this a little bit so that each prop is on its own line. This will make it a little bit easier to read. Okay, so let's create an inline style. So when you do this in JavaScript, it needs to be an object. So we'll use one set of curly brackets to specify that we're using JavaScript and the second set to define the object. Okay, we need to create our CSS variable. So we'll say double dashes left, and this is a string, so we'll wrap it in single quotes. And this is equal to our left style variable. And I could just say left style, but remember in CSS, we need that percentage sign on the end. So we can use string interpolation. So I'll wrap this with backticks, and then I'll put curly brackets around our variable with a dollar sign in front, and I'll stick our percentage sign on the end. Okay, I'm going to add a comma to the end of our line, and let's duplicate this and do the same thing for width. So let's give this a save and check this out within the browser. Aha, sweet. Okay, so let's change our chapter variables and see what happens. For the first chapter, I'm going to have this start at the very beginning and have it last 15 seconds. For the second chapter, I'm going to have it start at 60 seconds and go to the very end, so 75. Remember, our start and end can't exceed 75. Okay, so let's give this a save and check it out in the browser. Perfect. So our times are updated, but there is a little room for improvement. When the chapters start at the very beginning and the end of our clip, they have hard rectangular corners. They should have round corners to match the progress bar. And we can fix this pretty easily. So let's jump over to our CSS and create a style that we can add if the clip starts at the very beginning. So I'm going to say chapter start So whenever we have a chapter and a start class together, we want the border top left radius to be 10 pixels. And actually, let's stick our rounded corner into a variable since we're referencing it in multiple places. And then if it changes, we only need to update it once. So at the top of our file, right below our color variables, I'm gonna say rounded corner 10 pixels. Now let's do a quick search for 10 pixels. And I'm gonna replace this with var rounded corner. I'm going to copy this since we'll be changing, it looks like 8 instances of this. Okay, and let's duplicate this for the bottom. I'm going to copy and paste this, and we want to do the same thing at the end, but instead of left, it needs to be right. So I'm going to give that a save. Okay, so now let's use this within our JavaScript. So let's scroll down to our chapter. And right now within our JavaScript, we're saying that class name is JavaScript value styles.chapter, but we want it to possibly be a list of classes. And we can make this into a string and use string interpolation. So let's wrap our value in backticks and put curly brackets around it and add a dollar sign to the front. Now let's add some more JavaScript into our string to check to see if it starts at the beginning of our clip. So since we're using JavaScript again, I'm gonna use the dollar sign and curly brackets, and then we'll say chapter.start is equal to 0. So when this is true, double ampersands, we wanna display styles.start. Okay, then let's do the same thing for end. So I'm actually going to just copy this, put a space, and replace start. Then instead of 0, this is going to be if it's equal to duration. So I'm going to give that a save, and let's check it within our browser. Awesome, rounded corners. Okay, this looks great. As always, I've posted the code from this video on GitHub. Feel free to fork it, download it, use it, modify it, whatever, it's yours. If you like this video and want to see more videos on web design and development, be sure to hit the subscribe button below. Hit the bell icon to receive notifications when new videos are posted. Until then, keep coding. So I work for a company called ZEAL, and they're a software consultancy that designs custom applications and develops primarily in Rails and React. And ZEAL holds a special place in my heart because, well, as I mentioned, I work there. But I can honestly say it's the best place that I've ever worked, and good news for you, they are hiring, so you could work with me. At ZEAL, one of our core principles is bridge the gap. We've noticed there's a gap in the industry between juniors and seniors. So we want to help juniors level up and achieve that next level within their career path. With that in mind, I wanted to highlight a particular job that we're hiring for right now, which I'm super stoked about, and that's the software residency. This position is specifically for that junior designer, developer that wants to be mentored, level up, and eventually become a senior. This position is all about becoming a unicorn, for lack of a better word, but it's that person that can do UI, UX, and development. Similar to a medical residency, you'll be partnered with me, a senior, and we'll work together on projects. We'll also be partnering with Learn, which is a coding bootcamp, and they'll provide career growth and professional development through one-on-one coaching. So I think the whole setup is pretty unique, and you can find more information on the website, softwareresidency.com/ZEAL, and of course, I'll include a link within the description below.